Breaking news. Federal government suspends channels television, slams it with 5 million naira fine for letting hip-hop spec man speak on program. The Nigerian broadcast watchdog NBC was suspended channels television for airing Emmanuel Powerful, spokesman for separatist group, the Indigenous People of Biafran, on Sunday, being April 2021. The NBC also slammed a 5 million naira fine on the Lagos-based channel for allowing the IPOP social med alleged socialist and assisting declaration on air without caution or premiers. The punitive measures were announced by Prof. Armstrong Idashapa, the acting director general of commissioner, in the letting to the managing director of China's television Vanguard newspaper report. The fine were announced on Monday by broadcast media regulator NBC over the station's hearing of a spokesperson for separatist Indigenous People of Biafra on April 21, 2021, Vanguard reported. The NBC further accused the station of giving Powerful a free rein to make derogatory force and misleading statement about the Nigerian army, despite being proscribed as a court of law. The IPOP spokesman had denied the group is behind a deadly attack on the resident of Hope Uzodinma, governor of Imo State. China's television is still broadcasting as of the time this report was filed by SCOPA. NPC has recently scaled up. They have tracked down on radio and television station that air contact that appears to go against the will of the President Muhammadu Buhari-led government. Last year, the regulatory fined several broadcasters for hearing some critical materials about the NSAS campaign against police brutalities. IPOP was proscribed as a terrorist group in 2017 by the Nigerian government. Its leader, Nnamdi Kanu, fled the country shortly after being freed from detention on bail in 2018 and has not been seen near the country ever since then. SCOPA had meanwhile reported how 7 members of a militia group linked to the proscribed IPOP have been killed during a joint operation by the Nigerian police force, the Nigerian Army and Department of State Service in the early hours of Saturday. Security sources confirmed the incident, saying that 2 other members were also arrested in the joint operation. Among those killed is one suspected Commander Ikoso, identified as the Vice President's designate of IPOP. The late IPOP leader was also said to be the coordinator of all the operation of the group in the southeast, including the attack on the Imo police headquarters on April 5th and several other attacks on security and military personnel and facilities. Security operatives were said to have stormed the IPOP operational headquarters in Awumama village, Oru East local government area of Imo State, where they engaged the gunmen in exchange for fire. Commander Ikoso, alongside others of his colleagues, eventually fell to the superior firepower of the security operatives. Ikoso is said to have carried out series of violent attacks on security personnel and formations in the southeast and south-south of the country. The operation is part of deliberate efforts by the police and other security forces to kill the activities of insurgents in Imo State and other states of the southeast and south-south region of the country. The several sophisticated weapons, including 6 AK-47 rifles, 100 of ammunition of different caliber, and charms meant to went to ward of bullets were recorded and discovered from the gunmen. However, 3 policemen and 1 army officer are said to be receiving treatment, having sustained serious bullet injuries during the exchange of the gunfire. Imo State has been experiencing series of attacks of recent, with sources blaming the attacks on IPOB member. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. You can imagine. You can imagine. China's television must seek redress in the court of law. This is how an irresponsible government on the name of fine is working assiduously to gang up with IPOB member. You can imagine. See, federal government. The federal government and NBC should be ashamed of themselves. They should be ashamed of themselves. What has the IPOB spokesman done to them to ban them from talking on China's television? See, Boko Haram, banditry, Fulani herdsmen, kidnappers, and so on and so forth are all on the rampage in the north part of the country and have moved like whirlwind to other parts of the country. Yet, the federal government is comfortable. They are not doing anything about those people. Just because an IPOB spokesperson spoke on television, spoke on China TV concerning the crisis going on in the country, concerning the IPOB member ESN and the commander. Look at what is happening. Suspending China's television for allowing them to speak on China's TV. You can imagine. They should be ashamed of themselves. Soldiers have been butchered. Properties and lives are in burning fire. Yet, in the north. Yet, muzzles have been flexed wastefully on common issues. Imagine. Is this the country, Nigeria, were promised? Is it what they promised? Shame on the country. Shameless country. Very soon, the Nigerian government will be coming market women, will be coming market women, because everyone is talking about this stupid government. Useless nation. Zoo country. Nigeria will one day grow out of military rule very soon with its oppressive and suppressive tendencies. And the people with their own government that is truly democratic. This government of people, by the people, and for the people. This will collapse. Forget it. Nigeria won't grow up on the military, as I've said before. The government of the people will now know what the people are talking about. Useless set of country. Useless set of people. They should continue doing what they are doing. They should continue. You can imagine. China's civil must seek readiness. This is how a new responsible government on the name of collecting fine. How stupid these people are. How stupid they are. Infringe on people's right to freedom of expression. You can't let someone be free to say whatever he wants to say. Not because they came out to say things about the way things are going and the death of their IPOB commander. The next thing they do is to suspend the channel, the program, the channel, the TV. For what? Is it a crime to be free? This is a world of this country is a world of freedom. You can imagine. You can imagine. Nigerian will held Shekau video and push all the rubbish the Northern Islamist and killer Mietihala say. But we forbid China's television from speaking on IPOB to unravel the crisis situation in the Southeast. You can imagine that. Where is the press freedom? Where is the press freedom? Nigeria is drifting to what it cannot handle. They should be warned. When the time war comes, they can stay. They're just matching the tails of Imran Bikan. Imagine, they don't keep unity by creating provocations. You know that. But this is what they're trying to do.